Welcome to Office Mechanics. Coming up on today's show, we're going to take a look 365 days later since our last tour of Office 365 at the three top areas of innovation. We'll give you an end-to-end tour of Office 365 and demonstrate what's new, show you highlights spanning collaboration and insights, and we'll even take a look at new options to protect information and stay informed. By Julia White, General Manager in Office. Welcome.
Great to be here.
So 365 days on, if you watched the last show, what's changed over the last year?
Well, a lot, Jeremy. So in 1 year alone, we've had over 450 updates in Office 365 across the board. But let me highlight some big three ones. One, Office Everywhere across all devices, PC, Mac, iOS, Android, browser. So got the whole range covered. We also introduced our first new app to Office Sway, first app in a decade, joining us for great storytelling. The next area around personalized insight and collaboration, we launched the Office Graph. We now have signals across my content and my actions so we know what's happening and I can serve up interesting things like an app called Delve that tells me what's most relevant and clutter to get my unimportant email out of my inbox. And then new dashboards in Power BI so I can visualize my data even better than I could before. And the last, but certainly not least, is about protecting your data wherever it is. So things like MDM right now in Office 365, as well as data loss prevention across all aspects of Office 365.
So that's really great in terms of the last 365 days, but what are the next 365 days going to bring?
Well, the one big area of focus is around team collaboration, but let me show you what that looks like actually.
Okay.
So let me start in here in Delve, again, powered by the Office Graph, where I can start and see all my information. But I'm going to use the Smart Intelligent Search here to find my design group that I want to work with. So go ahead and type that. I get into my Office 365 group. So this is kind of the fabric that runs across all parts of teamwork. However I want to work, I get my team view here. So if I go into the profile of that team, you can see who's on live, who's right now hot from Skype for Business. I have meetings, I have content, I have my email. I have my OneNote notebooks, Yammer, everything's right here. I can see members. And again, it's lightweight. I can add new people, they can remove. It's no IT required in the middle, so the users can just be empowered to do that. But let's talk about working in the app. So let me switch over to Outlook 2016, one of my favorite apps.
Yes.
And talk about modern collaboration. So let me send an email here to Ben, and I'm gonna send him my plan, but I'm gonna attach a file. And I'm going to just do the same workflow I always have, but now I have my most recently used documents right there when I go to add, because I'm usually working on something and then I want to go collaborate on it.
And that saves a lot of time in terms of trying to find where that file was stored. Whether it was locally on the machine or in the cloud,
right.
I can just see everything I've been working on recently.
Right, I just one click and there it is. And now you say I grab it and you see that little cloud, it means it's actually not an attachment. It's just sharing it from OneDrive. And the best part is when I hit send, it gives Ben permissions. I don't have to worry about it. And I can even go down here and change permissions right within Outlook if I wanted.
Very cool.
Hit send, and it goes to Ben. He gets access, permissions handled, and now we're collaborating real time in one single version of the document. And now also,
right.
I can add Skype to that. We can be collaborating with Skype. I can be in the browser experience, and now the desktop experience to do that as well. But last but not least, let me go back and show you our great new app called Sway. So go ahead, and now this is coming to the Office 365 commercial and education plans. I'll go ahead and log into my Sways where I can see what I've been working on. And go into my collective project here, the Sway that I've been updating, and it drops me into the edit view. And I want to show how simple it is, right? This is just tap, drag, or drop to make a change to my Sway. And I can go over and look at what my Sway looks like. You know, beautiful, I have video embedded, I have pictures, I can do all sorts of things. And maybe I say, gosh, this Blue Man Group video is
a little bit big.
Yeah, don't you think? Let me go down and take care of that real simply. So I just go down to that component, that video. Click here, and I can say modify. And again, I'm not giving it specific commands. I'm just saying, yeah, make that more subtle. And there, it just will resize that for me, and I can go back and take a look at what it looks like. Much better.
Yes.
Yeah.
So even beyond that, in terms of team collaboration, you've done a lot there too, right?
So much around team collaboration. There's going to be a lot more to come as well. So let me go back. To Delve, and what we talked about for the first time yesterday, really exciting, is tapping into that Office Graph experience. I can actually show org things, not just my own personalized information. So if I go and show that new experience, you can see I can see a whole bunch of things about me and my time, but also my team as well. So I can see how the interactions of my team, the kind of communications that are being sent. And I can check on my own work-life balance with simple things like how many emails or meetings am I doing outside of work hours. And I can even go down here and get a deeper click of a trend line of how much time I'm spending spending in meetings. So I get an assessment of that, plus a comparison to my peers in the organization. But if I want to go in deeper and see what's the interactions going on with my team to other teams and even outside the company. And the thickness of that line is the intensity of the interactions between the teams. And I can just filter down on anything to get a sense of how is my team connected or not and really help us all collaborate better. And then, of course, talking about visualization and cool things like that, let's talk about Power BI too.
One of my favorite tools.
Who doesn't love it? So all of my data here, but it's easy for me to drill down and get more. Maybe I want to see more about this gross revenue here. I could just select that, and I can keep drilling down as deep as I want, but here maybe I'm just going to go ahead and edit this, and I have this gross margin and gross revenue, but really what I wish is I had both of those things together, and now super simple, I grab it and we call bump it together. I just drop it right on top. Power BI does the work to say, what's the best visualization for that new data? Combine the data sets together, and now I have the view that I want.
Very cool. So all of this is really part of our mission to keep you informed with the most filtered down, most relevant information possible. But on the IT side, when we think about it, there's so much information being created and shared. We have to help IT protect that information without getting in the way of end user productivity. So we've done a lot here in terms of Office 365. And if we switch back over to my computer, you'll see here that we have a brand new Compliance Center experience that really lets you do several new things in Office 365. We have the ability now to manage mobile devices straight from Office 365, which enables new things like selective wipe. I can just selectively delete the things that I put on that computer or that mobile device, whether it's email, whether it's a hook into OneDrive for Business. Even as I'm coming into data through PowerPoint and Excel and Word, all of those will broker that management connectivity between MDM here in Office 365. And as I selectively wipe that device, the cool thing is I can keep all the user's personal data and personal files on that device and just delete what belongs to me from a management perspective. But we're even going beyond all of that with data loss prevention. So data loss prevention is something else. I can create policies that regardless of how people are creating information, if they contain sensitive information like credit card information, they're sharing that outside the organization, we can find that, whether it's in Mail, whether it's in OneDrive for Business or SharePoint. Let me just show you what that looks like in OneDrive on my computer. Because I have here a couple of files that actually have sensitive information. Here's a Project Falcon customer data document. That already sounds a bit suspicious. But if I click in on that, I'll see that this is actually sensitive information containing. I have a policy tip that I can look at and see exactly what's going on with this document. And you can see here the items actually shared with people outside my organization. And it contains a credit card number. So all of these things are things that I probably don't want to have people share with outside of my organization. So really making it pervasive, regardless of how I'm actually building that data. It doesn't have to go through mail transport. It can be everything in OneDrive or SharePoint Online that we can actually identify.
And it's been so popular with email in terms of those policy, the DLP policy tips in email, and now we have it in OneDrive and SharePoint as well.
Really powerful. So even beyond all of that, we're doing a lot in terms of auditing. So all of this can be tracked and audited in terms of any activity. Somebody leaves my organization, I can see exactly what they've worked on their last week on the job, or if a file is leaked out, I can see exactly who's touched it prior to that happening. So I get all of that reporting, but one of the things I'm really excited about is Power BI and the new content pack that's coming for Office 365. So I'll be able to view exactly who's using the service, how popular the various workloads are, and I got all the power within Power BI to do all of the visualizations around geographical information. Here, if I look at my email client distribution, for example, this is all real-time data that I can query down and see. If I want to see, for example, who's using mobile clients across my engineering or finance or other teams, I can just click on mobile and it automatically will filter that down, give me a view, even show me on the map all of these things. So this is really powerful information from an admin perspective. And this is really, from a tour perspective, these are just some of the things that are coming or have been delivered in the recent months. I'm really excited about all of this more stuff that's coming. It will continue to evolve. So it's amazing how much we've been doing and how much it's going to continue to evolve in the future.
Absolutely. And right now, and that's also because of all the incredible feedback. We're listening to you guys. We're listening to our customers of what they want. And now with the cloud, we can actually turn it around. So I've gotten great feedback here at Ignite. I can take that back and say, let's get that in the next release in a quarter. And we can turn that around so quickly.
And of course, all of this information, we try to be as transparent as possible with the information, what we're going to be releasing with the Office Roadmap. You can stay up to date with new features that are actually coming into Office 365. Also with the Office blog, as every news item hits, all the new features that come out, even things that we're working on, all of that's through Office blogs. And here on Office Mechanics, we try to stay up to date with all the news. So you can do a lot to get started with this, right?
Yeah, and if you haven't gotten started and you're interested, it's super easy to get your trial going. Just set it up, get a few users in there, and you get a sense of how it works. It's really easy.
So that's about all the time we have today for this show. Thank you all for watching, and goodbye for now.